The thing is, Phillip, no matter how hard you try, you'll never, ever be able to give it to him the way I do him.
Hey, what's up? What's going on, you guys? You have now tuned in to my Empire Season 3, Episode 12 recap. Guys, be sure to subscribe if you haven't yet done so. Also, be sure to share this video wherever you like to share videos. And don't forget to give it that good old thumbs up. All right, let me go ahead and find our Empire recap.
Wait, Sandy.
All right, so shout out to 503 Lion from last week, who was like, what's the deal with Nia Long and Cookie? Good review, though. I can't wait to see your Power reviews. Oh, my God. I can't wait for Power to come back, too. Like, Power is my show, y'all. Like, seriously, like, between Empire and Power, I don't even know. Like, they both have, like, different things that I really and truly enjoy about them. And Perfect Imperfections was like, from what I heard, Nia Long was being disrespectful to the Empire staff. Ooh, okay, sips a little tea. I ain't know about all that. I mean, she don't seem like the diva type to me, but you know, I don't know, because I've only seen her act. I actually seen her in person once years ago at when I used to go to, what was it? 106 in Park as a child. Well, I wasn't a child. I was like a teenager. She was there promoting some show. So, yeah, that was the only time I seen her. But she seemed cool. I mean, I don't really remember it that well. And most of the shows you see her in is either, like, sad shows. This is the first time I seen her in this type of devious role. Like, now you would think she's a diva in this particular role. But I don't know. I'm going to look through the blogs and see if I see anything. So, yeah, the Hakeem, he's about to be 21, honey. I thought he was older than that from the way he be acting. I mean, this dude been acting grown for a while. So, we kind of met him, I guess, as a teenager, if we go according to, like, seasons. So, if it was season one, he was probably, like, 19 or so. And then 2021. So, yeah, he's partying early, you know, in bed with a whole bunch of people, looking like a whole menage a trois type of thing, orgy or whatever. Menage a trois is like three people, right? So, like, an orgy situation from the way everybody was all spread out all over the place. And later on, when he goes to see his papa and he goes to see his mama as well to kind of ask, you know, what's up? Like, what gift they gonna get him? What party they throwing for him? Like, you know, what's the 411 on the secret that they got for him? And they just like, you know, we gotta clean up some messes right now. That's not on our top of our list. That's not top priority at the moment. He talking about he wants some expensive car. They like, you know, his dad is just like, how is it that you managed to allow Anika to leave and abandon the baby? He's like, wait, what? You know, he was like totally lost. He ain't know nothing about nothing, because all he was doing was thinking about his birthday and not really anything else. That was pretty much it. Jamal got the goodies from, I think that was his mentor, right? From his mentor, Phillip. I mean, I knew it was bound to happen. And didn't it happen before, or they just been flirting? Well, it happened. And at the same time, he gets some little, like, you know, notice on his phone. He looks at it, but kind of like drops it on the floor and notices that it's Derek doing like a live broadcast. And Derek is straight up like coming out to the world through his live broadcast and literally is like, you know, I'm coming, Jamal. Oh, the embarrassing moment when somebody is like doing something major, yet kind of embarrassing as well, and wants to put your name in it, giving you props. Like, don't give me props for that. I say I want it to be part of your coming out story. This is for you, not for me. What you doing? So, yeah, he pretty much does that, and he ends up at the crib because he already had, like, the car key to come up. And when Jamal sees this, he tells Phillip to kind of, like, hurry up and get ready. And, you know, he didn't tell him why. And in walks homeboy, like, straight up still video chatting on his phone. I think he, like, good thing he didn't have it turned around, like, trying to show his face. But that would have been kind of disrespectful because you don't know how this person looks. Because I was wondering how it was that he, like, straight came up in his house like that. But that's because he had the car key, which we learned later on. So, yeah, he straight up came and he's like, he looked like he was, like, shocked, hurt, mortified. But this dude, like, I just feel like he's so tough, or he pretends to be tough. Like, he has this, like, image. And for him to act that way, it was kind of shocking to me. So, Phillip ended up leaving after that so they could kind of, like, talk. But Jamal was just, he wasn't really with it right now, and he was just, like, annoyed that the dude just straight came up into his house like that. So, yeah. Neesa, she was on stage singing, and Juelianna comes in and says that she was kind of flirting a lot with Andre and just was like, wow, she's a lucky girl. And Juelianna, she's trying to, like, it seems like she's trying to take over and become the boss of Empire or something like that. And she wants Andre's help, which is why she keeps on flirting with him and acting the way she is with him. So now Cookie is with Angelo, and he finds out that she has a gun that she keeps. And he was just like, nah, you gotta get rid of that because the life that we're living and what we're trying to do, this cannot be a part of it. Like, we're on some next level. Like, we're not with that hood. He pretty much saying, like, yo, we're not with that hood-ish, all right? Like, we on some professional. I'm trying to be mayor. I can't be walking around with a girl who walks around with freaking guns in her pocketbook. Like, that ain't hot. That ain't cool. What you doing? You gonna mess up my image? What if somebody catch you? Like, you already a felon. What you doing? So she's like, you know what, she's gonna get rid of it. Another reason why she's so attached to it from the flashback that we saw is because, not number one, was that Lucius was the one who gave it to her, and number two was that there was a guy that was trying to take advantage of her at one point. It seems like it was one of Lucius' friends. She said he wasn't there when he came over, and he's like, you know what, I'm not here for Lucius. They started, like, trying to rub on her leg. So she straight up took Lucius' gun and just kind of, like, ended up shooting the dude because the dude called her bluff and was just like, you don't even know how to use that. She straight shot him in the kneecaps, though. I bet you he limping today because them knee injuries do not heal fast. I tell you that much from experience. I ain't get shot in the knee, thank the Lord, but, you know, I had some issues with my knee because I got hit by a car. So, yeah, and it's still going on. This was, like, back in 2008. So now Derek, following that, let's see. Derek, he goes to Jamal again at the studio, and they just have, like, a heart-to-heart a little bit. And Jamal had to tell him that he should have told him before he decided, like, oh, let me come out to the world on a live broadcast and come to your house. You know, like, you did it way backwards. He's like, but I was doing this for you because you said this was what you wanted. And this is the only way that you'd be able to be with me. I'm like, well, hot diggity dog. Now you want to make moves after a dude then started looking at somebody else and got a taste of a new penis? Like, now you want to make some moves? So, Derek just seems like he's not really handling everything well. Like, people are starting to disown him. I mean, this is all part of the process, especially when you're a hip-hop or a rapper or a hip-hop artist, and you've been maintaining this tough boy, rude boy kind of image for so long. Like, what do you expect? Like, how you go from, I'm tough boy, rude boy, to, you know, I'm a gay man? You know, it's hard for people to grasp, and they will come at you because people are ignorant, and that's just how it is. I mean, it's gotten a lot better with the time, but it's still like crazy out there. So yeah, he says that he's losing gigs and things like that, and it, to me, it kind of seemed like it was for nothing, because it seems like Jamal is just, like, not at a place where he's trying to be with him. And he's still, like, just, like, kind of chilling. I mean, Jamal has his own issues and demons that he's battling. He can't be, like, really rushing into a relationship, especially with somebody who's hurt him so much. Like, he was literally begging to be with this guy. And this guy was like, you're going to be in the shadows type of thing. You're going to be my, nobody knows about you. And that's not a good feeling. I've been in relationships where it's been like, you know, you're a secret. Like, bitch, I don't want to be a secret. I want everybody to know about me. I want to show my face. I want to take pictures for Instagram and Twitter. Was Instagram around? I think Instagram might have been around. Or maybe it was before that. But anyway, that sounds like I'm mad old. But yeah, like, you know, you don't want to be nobody's dirty little secret. That don't sound cute. That don't feel good. So, now Hakeem is having his birthday party, and he goes to a club, he does live streaming, and then when he was done, I guess he only had to appear for about 15 minutes, because that's how it is with celebrities. They appear for a few minutes, and they get a good amount of money, especially depending on how big you are in the world, how many followers you have, and things like that. So, he was doing his own live stream, so that's going to be on the Empire stuff, you know what I mean? So, yeah, the club is getting some good stuff from that, some good promotion. I was wondering why he couldn't remember the name of the club. He had to, like, read it off his hand. Did y'all check that? So, yeah, he goes to the club owner to get his money, and dude straight up try to play him, like, on some, oh, we'll give you this. He's like, you're supposed to give me 50 G's or something like that. And he was just like, nah, we're going to give you this because did you think them bottles was free? Do you think them champagne bottles and all of that stuff was free? Nah, you got that comes out of your money. Like, wait, hold up. Don't be playing with my money, bro. Don't be playing with my money. So he's like, see, that wasn't part of the deal. That's not what we agreed on. He's like, well, who's going to do something? Like, club owner was straight up being a little B. Like, who's going to do something? You don't got nobody else here. I don't see your brother here. I don't see your daddy here. Like, ain't nobody else as famous except you, you know? Who else gonna do something? So all of a sudden, these two dudes, I call them goons, they come out showing their guns and stuff. So that definitely got him to kind of switch up the way he was feeling and kind of say something else. He just kind of says, you know what? This seems to have been a misunderstanding. Here goes your money. And, of course, Hakeem being the Hakeem that he is, he also takes their watches. And he also throws them a little bit of cash. Like, here goes your money for them bottles. I'm like, bro, at the end of the day, you know you don't really need the money. We all know that. But do you got to waste it like that? Like, he was wasting money left and right. I'm like, well, hot diggity dog. I'll be a stripper for the night. I mean, just throw it over here, bro. I mean, because you're throwing it everywhere. Like, it's nothing. It's just really literally paper, you know? And then because of these guys being so nice to him, loyal, and helping him to get that money, he decides to give them, I think he gave them watches and he gave them money. And he's like, you know what? Y'all cool dudes. Y'all rolling with me. Like, don't know these people from nowhere. They got guns, but you gonna allow them to come with you to your other event, to hang out with you for your birthday. I mean, yes, it's nice and everything that they held you down. At the end of the day, I probably would have left them, give them a little bit of money or whatever, maybe like getting 50 G's, give them 500 each, and be on your way. I mean, not some, oh, let's go, like, you know them like that. What you doing? You moving funny. Like, you moving wrong. That's what I should say. You moving wrong, because, yeah, that was stupid. So, and I'm just looking at him like, this can't be good. So he goes up into his club, you know, for his family and everything. Everything was going good, you know. It was all alright. But before we talk about that, let's talk about how Anika, she pops up, right? So Anika, she pops up and Lucius lets Cookie know that she's back. So they go to where she was at. She thought she was going to pick up the baby and play with her little baby and all that, but that wasn't going to go down because Lucius needed to talk to her, as well as Cookie. So they talk to her, pretty much letting her know they don't really trust her right now. They could kill her. In walks the mama like, do I let me do it? I do it. You know, she was ready because, you know, she was part of this whole plan, so she was ready. He's like, mama, let me just do what I gotta do. Go back, please. Mama comes back a little bit later with a gun. You're like, where the hell you get a gun from? She gets the gun from Cookie's pocketbook, honey. Oh, they took the gun away from her, but she really wants to eliminate this girl. Like, she was not feeling her at all. And Anika now has a plan, but I'm like, the plan might get foiled because at the end of the day, the mom, she kind of heard it, and the mom is working with Tyreek. So if she gets a chance to get a hold of him, either by way of phone or sneaks out again, then he's going to find out the plan and he's going to mess it up, you know? So her plan now is to get Tyreek to get involved with her, I guess, give him the goodies and have proof that they did something. And then after that, just kind of get him off the case. But they don't even know. He's not even really on the case. So, I mean, I guess at the end of the day, she might end up being the big fool out of this because he's, like, on a pretend case. Like, that case is fake. Didn't his chief take him off of the case anyway? So, yeah, you're gonna have sex with him for no reason. Sucks to be you because he's creepy. Now, Derek comes back to Jamal's crib again. I told you something, right? Like, he's going off. He's going off, and that's because he got some, I guess, good D or whatever, and he don't know how to act no more. He's hooked and mesmerized and dickmatized and all that. So, yeah, he goes to Jamal's crib trying to swipe himself in, and it wasn't working. Like, he shut him down. Then, just so happens that Phillip came through. He was coming through first, and Jamal was kind of behind, I guess, so it doesn't look too suspicious. And then they have, like, a little bit of war of the words, you know, a little confrontation. And that's where Phillip proceeds to tell him, like, you know, you'll never do it as good as I can. So, surprisingly, did I say Phillip or Derek? Derek was the one who said that. And then, surprisingly, Phillip punches him in his face. And I felt like, you know what? With this whole situation, it's crazy because I look at them and I see, and I look at Jamal and I see his mom. You know, because, and it's crazy because they say a lot of times patterns run in families and you do the same thing that your parents do. And I kind of see that sometimes with certain situation in my family as well. You know, you see a lot of the mistakes that you heard that your parents made that you were like, oh, I would never do that. You do. And it's like, what the hell? Like, why is this happening? Is this fate or something? But yeah, it's like the same exact thing where she's in love pretty much with two people. She's got Angelo, who's like really refined, who's uplifting, who's there to help, who's a little more on the, you know, uppity side. And then she has that hood dude. That's the Lucius Lion, you know, the Lucifer dude that's down for whatever, that's ready to take people's heads off, you know? If they had to pick like, what would Lucius be on the astronomy sign symbol? I would definitely call him a Scorpio from the way he is. I mean, I'm just saying, he gotta be. So, yeah, and you see, that's the exact same way that I feel like Phillip is. Like, Phillip is more refined. He seems very educated. He just seems like, you know, he's a little more of an uplifting type of person that would be good for him. But then he also has this dude over here, Derek, who's like raw, who's a little more hood, who, like, you know, is really like out there and just everybody knows him and he gotta always portray this certain image. So I just feel like, you know, he's just like his mama in that sense. And it was funny because when he had seen his mama, she kind of told him that he had to, like, you know, kind of choose Phillip or whatever, or he gonna lose Phillip. And then he was like, yeah, just like you. And she like, don't talk about me. You know, this ain't about me. So, yeah, back to Hakeem, right? So, yeah, he's in the club. He has a good time. Tiana sings for him. And his brother Jamal performs for him, too. It's just, like, real nice. But one of them goon dudes, he tries to talk to one of Tiana's friends. And the friend wasn't really feeling him like that. She like, nah, get off of me. And then he's like pulling her mad hard, like, nah, chill, get off of me. And dudes be doing this in the club, it's mad annoying. Like, I'm not missing the club days right now. Like, I'm so over clubs right now. Like, I think I could do a lounge or maybe even a bar, but bars are more so, I feel, for, like, sports. And I'm not really a sports type of chick. I definitely do a lounge, so, like, that's grown and sexy, you know what I mean? Or, like, a day club. I want to see the lights one. Nah, only if it's on like a rooftop thing. I think that's all I can do, like a day club. Other than that, I think that's whack. So yeah, so they're at the club or whatever, and yeah, the dude is just like all trying to grab her up. So she's like, nah. He straight up punches her in her face, like, yo, like, punches her like she was a straight up dude. Like, it was not even cool the way he did that. So Hakeem says something on the mic. Because he looked like he really, like, this is not the first time I've seen him kind of defend somebody that was kind of getting, you know, beat up or something by a guy. And so at least we know he, you know, he got some sense. So, yeah, he was doing that. And everything just kind of spun out of control. Like, Tiana's friends was, like, beating the guys, hitting them with stuff. People was, like, running out the club. It was just, like, real crazy. And it was all being live streamed, too. Plus, on top of that, people had their phones. And I'm looking at them like, if I was one of the patrons in the club, I would not be talking about some, let me put this on. Like, maybe I'll do a snap as I'm running out, but not no, like, let me try to get this viral snap right here or this viral Instagram live or something. Because first of all, Instagram live is not, it don't even last, you know, it's gonna be away in a few minutes. And Snapchat, you know, you can always do it on that, but like, who got time for all that? It's mad complicated to do all of that extra stuff and be like, I mean, you know, you get caught in the crossfires. Like, I'm like, y'all really is just really into social media. But this is what people really do in real life, and it's sad, you know? It's something crazy, a crazy situation going down. There's a fire burning building, you know, all these crazy things, and you're out here like, look what's going on. I can't believe it. There's smoke. There's fire. Oh my gosh. There's fire going everywhere. It almost hit me. Oh my gosh. Like, what are you doing? Run, move out of the way. Don't get hurt. So yeah, that's pretty much what was happening. And Andre, after this was all done, Andre talks to, well, first it was Jamal that talked to him and was just like, you know, you gotta kind of grow up right now, because it's these lyrics that you're talking about, like, you need to change up your style or whatever, because you're older now. And then Andre comes to him and he was just like, what are you, crazy? Like, you gave these dudes gifts and money? This makes it seem like, I guess there's some law that says that means that they're like employees. And look at all the craziness. And he was like, you know what, you're shut down now and you're not going to be able to live stream for ever, like ever again. And, you know, of course they was upset with each other. I mean, it really looked like they was about to fight next, but luckily they didn't. But he was just like, you know what, this is shut down. That's it. Andre has laid down the law. And that was the end of that. Juelianna, she speaks to Andre. They have like a little meeting. And she was like flirting hard. I mean, this girl knows how to get to him. I mean, she probably uses her body quite often. And she actually did meet with Cookie earlier. Like, I didn't talk about that, but she did. And she was just kind of really like, she sat in Cookie's chair at the time that she was supposed to be getting her hair done with her hairdresser, and had goons there, and she gave like mad money. So her hairdresser was kind of like compromised at the end of the day. She couldn't really say, oh, you know, I'm gonna make her get up because you're a hair, Cookie. Like, regardless to who you are, she paid more. So yeah. And when, as Cookie was leaving, she was like, it's okay, I know you had to throw out the trash. The hairdresser looked like she was so uncomfortable when she said that, because, you know, that's her client, and a good client. But what are you going to say, no, she's not trash, and then possibly lose this client and the money that you want and need? So yeah, Juelianna, she speaks to Andre, flirting with him and everything, and he wants to take her back to the crib. And she's like, you know what, does your girl know about this? And he was like, she's good with it. He was like, this is the way I do business. This is the way I've always done business. And in my head, I'm just thinking, and I'm like, I don't remember him telling Neesa that this is the way he does business. I mean, maybe I could be wrong. Maybe I forgot something. But I don't remember them having a conversation about that. Like, oh, I'm going to have sex with other women to get deals because this is what I've always done. I don't remember that conversation. I remember he used to do it with, what's her name, Rhonda? That was her name, right? I don't forgot the girl's name. It's been so long. But yeah, he used to do it with his ex-wife. I know that. But as far as Neesa, I don't remember that being established, but he said it was, and that's the way he does business. But she was like, no, I don't touch other men, other women's property without their permission. So she was just like, you know, we're not going there. He was just like, you know what, let's go back. Where you want to take this? We can go. Like, he was ready for her. I'm like, damn, Andre, you thirsty. I ain't never seen dude so thirsty before. He done got over his ex now. He done tasted that Neesa juice, but he want a little more juice. He want some dirty juice. He like the way she move, honey. So, yeah, they talk, and she wants to make some deal with him, and she was saying that she wants to do business with him and Empire, and she'll have her people contact him. So she's trying to keep, now at the end when he's like, you know, pretty much putty in her hands, she kind of takes it back to the business role. So she kind of plays with his head a little bit. She's doing dealings with some bad guys that her husband or boyfriend, whoever the hell he was to, the one that she killed off, was dealing with. And she gives them like a whole bunch of money in a bag, and they want to have some kind of business with Empire. So she's ready to make that happen. She's like, you know, she's going to do it. And I'm pretty sure that's why she's so close to Andre, because she knows right now he's pretty close to his dad, and that would be the best way to kind of like worm your way into that spot. You know what I mean? Worm your way into it. Hakeem goes to see his father late at night, like after this whole thing went down, and Tiana kind of left him to go see her friends, and she just kind of felt like he was being selfish, because the only thing that he was thinking about was, oh my God, my birthday's ruined. Like, not all the craziness that happened, not is your friend okay, none of that. So she was just like over him at that point and went to go see her friend in the hospital. And he went over to his father's house and said that he would like to have his, he went like picking up the baby, and his father's like, where are you going with her at this time of night? And he's just like, I want to spend the rest of my birthday with her. And he just kind of gave him a story, and just kind of was like, he seemed like he was proud of him. Like, I thought that it was going to be a twist where he would be like, you know, give him some good part of the story and then kind of twist it and make it a crappy story or a guilt-ridden story or something like that, or tell him he can't take the baby. But he actually seemed like he had, like, something in his eyes, and he was like, you know, because you're the youngest, he might have, you know, allowed him to do things he shouldn't have done. He got away with a lot of things, but he also let him know that he did deliver him, and he always wanted to be, like, early at everything he did. And he was actually, like, really proud of him that he was, like, stepping up and taking care of his responsibility. So, yeah, that was a really nice moment between them. Definitely looking forward to seeing what happens next week, you guys. Let me know what you thought about this episode down below for your chance to get your comment posted, well, presented in my next video. Shout outs. Stay fabulous, live free, and soar limitless. I'll see you in the next one. Later.